Can you see the slide? Guys, I guess you can see the slide. Can you see the slide?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Okay. So I am going to discuss about physical control of plant pathogens. So you can see here today, I will discuss so you will know what is biological control, what are the benefits of using the biological control measures, how can we control the plant pathogen, especially with the help of biological control, or how the plant pathogen can control or can be controlled by the biological control agent, and what are the requirements of successful biocontrol. And I will give you some example on biocontrol. So this term was first proposed by Harry Smith, and he was working with the insect, especially biocontrol of insect, and he dealt with the suppression of insect population by some native or introduced enemies of insect. You know that we can control the insect pest by a number of beneficial insects and also by a number of plant pathogen, by a number of pathogen actually. So the fungi, bacteria, virus, nematodes. So this group of microorganisms don't cause to disease to plant only, but this group of microorganisms can cause infection to the insect. So we can exploit this group of microorganisms to cause infection to the insect, especially to the harmful insect. And by this way, we can control the harmful insect. Okay. Actually, this is a population leveling process in which the population of one organism lowers the population of another organism. So this is called biocontrol. For example, you know, in the kingdom, especially in the microorganism, there are some microorganisms, those are beneficial, and there are some microorganisms, those are harmful. We can exploit those beneficial microorganisms to control the harmful microorganism. Okay? So this is we call biocontrol. And there are beneficial fungi, beneficial bacteria, beneficial nematode, and beneficial insect as well. So we can exploit this beneficial microorganism to control or to manage the harmful microorganism, the group we call pathogen or pest. So why do we need to use the biological control agent or biocontrol agent? You know that the chemical pesticides we use to control the pest or to control pathogen or to prevent the disease or to control the disease, those are cost effective. Those are not very costly. The price is not very high. Those are cost effective. And the chemical pesticide is easy to apply with the help of knapsack sprayer or other foot pump sprayer or other kinds of sprayer. We can easily apply pesticide in the field, in the field crops, in the vegetable crops, in the fruit plants as well. And these are broad spectrum. It means one pesticide can kill several group of my pathogen, for example, or one pesticide sometimes may be effective to control a number of disease. But on the other hand, biological control agents are costly, and they're labor intensive. So if we want to use the biopesticide or biofungicide or any kind of bioproduct to control the pest, so it requires lots of labor, and these are especially host specific, whereas the chemical pesticide is broad spectrum, but still we use biocontrol. We suggest the farmers to use biocontrol. Why? You can see here, chemical pesticides, it actually cause problem to the ecology, to the environment, and it causes problem to the human health as well. And chemical pesticide require yearly treatment, not only yearly treatment, but also frequent treatment. Even to cultivate rice, for example, we need to spray chemical pesticide 3 to 4 times within 3 to 4 months. Okay, and these are broad spectrum. It means the chemical pesticide is toxic to both beneficial and pathogenic species. So in the soil, in the plant, there are millions of beneficial microbes. You know the ratio of beneficial to harmful microbe, that is 95% to 5%. So in an environment, the proportion of beneficial microorganism is 95%, whereas the percent of harmful microorganism is only 5%. So when we apply chemical pesticide, they don't kill only the harmful pest or a harmful microorganism, they also kill beneficial microorganisms. So these are all the bad effect of chemical pesticides. On the other hand, biological control agent or bioagents, those are not toxic to human. Those are not toxic to non-target microorganism. So not a water contaminant concern. You know it, the biological chemical pesticide contaminant water, especially the natural sources of fish or other group of microorganism, for example, pond or other source of water. So chemical pesticide pollutes these water sources. On the other hand, biological control agents don't pollute the water sources. And when we apply chemical pesticide, so if we apply this year, we also have to apply the next year. But on the other hand, if we apply the biological control agent, if we apply this year, we don't need to apply in the next year. So biological control agent, once after application, it will establish in the environment and it will survive in the environment years after years. And biological control agents are host specific. It has effect only to one, two or few species to the plant or a few species of microorganism. On the other hand, the chemical pesticides are toxic to beneficial, and it is broad spectrum. It kills both beneficial and harmful microorganisms. That is why we need to use biological control agents in order to control plant disease, in order to prevent the spread of the plant disease, in order to manage the plant pathogen. So how actually the beneficial microorganism, or we call biocontrol agents, control the harmful microorganisms? How does it happen? So there are some mechanisms by which these biocontrol agents control the harmful microorganism. You can see here antibiosis. What happens actually, there are some fungi, there are some bacteria which produce antibiotic. The secrets of chemical, those serve as antibiotic. And this antibiotic can kill the harmful microorganism. So this process we call antibiosis. You can see here, and most of the beneficial fungi and bacteria living in the soil, soil-borne microorganisms, they produce antibiotic. For example, you can see here, Deuteromycin A. This is an antibiotic, and this antibiotic is produced by the bacterium, Bacillus cereus. And this antibiotic is effective to control Phytophthora root rot in alfalfa. So this Deuteromycin, this is a antibiotic produced by the beneficial bacterium, Bacillus cereus. And this antibiotic can control this oomycete, Phytophthora. Okay, and this oomycete cause root rot in alfalfa. You know, Pythium and Phytophthora present in the soil, and they cause infection to the root zones especially. And this Phytophthora can be controlled by the antibiotic, which is produced by the bacterium Bacillus cereus. Bacillus cereus, this is a beneficial bacterium, rhizobacterium, present in the root zone of the soil, of the plant. So this process is known as antibiosis. There is another mechanism how the biocontrol agent control the harmful microorganism or pathogen, that is nutrient competition. So this biocontrol compete with the pathogen for nutrient, for a wide range of nutrient, you know, carbon, nitrogen, oxygen, iron, and other nutrients. So, you know, these nutrients are required not only for the plant, but also for the microorganism. So what happens when we deploy the biocontrol agent in the environment? The biocontrol agent will take this nutrient, and there will be competition between the biocontrol agent and the harmful microbes or pathogen. So in this competition, the biocontrol agents win. As a result, the pathogen don't get enough nutrient for to survive in the environment, for growth, development, and reproduction. The pathogen will not get enough nutrient element in this competition. As a result, the pathogen will be weaker with the advancement of time. On the other hand, the biocontrol agent will be stronger with the advancement of time. So as a result, because of this competition, the pathogen become weak and weaker, and with the advancement of time, it will be weakest, and they lost their energy to cause infection to the plant, the pathogen, because the pathogen don't get the sufficient nutrient element, so their growth, development, and reproduction will be stopped. They will become weak, and as a result, they lost their ability to cause infection to the plant. So in this way, the biocontrol agent control the plant disease by weakening the plant pathogen. They control the plant disease. You can see here, Pseudomonas fluorescens. This is a beneficial bacterium. This prevents bacterial blooms by competing with. You can see here, Pseudomonas tolaci. You know the Pseudomonas fluorescens is beneficial. On the other hand, Pseudomonas tolaci is harmful. You know, there are variations within the same species. There might be some bacteria, there might be some pathogen which are beneficial, there are some pathogen which might be harmful. And this is one example of this. You can see here another mechanism how the biocontrol agent control the plant pathogen. That is mycoparasitism. You know the term parasitism, and there is another term myco. Myco means fungi. That is the parasitism of one fungus by another fungus. What happens here actually? For example, the beneficial fungus come in contact with the harmful fungus. Then what happens? The beneficial fungus secretes some enzyme, and those are cell degrading enzyme. For example, cellulose is the carbohydrate, or this is the component of cell wall, and cellulase is the enzyme which is secreted by the beneficial fungus. Cellulase enzyme can degrade cellulose, that is the component of cell wall. And some produce antibiotics, you already know. For example, Trichoderma hartzianum. This is a beneficial fungus, widely used beneficial fungus, available in the natural environment, used as seed treating agent and soil treating agents. So what happens? When this Trichoderma fungus come in contact with the another fungus, they actually capture, this Trichoderma will capture the harmful fungus. They will secrete some enzyme. As a result, the cell wall of the harmful fungus will be degraded, and after that, they absorb nutrient from the harmful fungus. This is known as mycoparasitism. As a result, the harmful pathogen become weak, become denatured, you know, and become weak. On the other hand, the beneficial fungus become stronger. So in this way, the beneficial microorganism control the plant disease or control the plant pathogen. So this is the mechanism, especially the three mechanism: mycoparasitism, antibiosis, and competitions. So by this way, the biocontrol agent or beneficial fungi or bacteria control the harmful fungi, bacteria, and nematodes. So what are the requirements of successful biocontrol? Highly effective biocontrol strain must be obtained or produced. The beneficial microbe should be highly effective, and it must be obtained or produced from the natural environment. We cannot synthesize or we cannot produce in the lab the biocontrol agent. So it must be available in the environment, especially in the soil, especially in the rhizosphere, and especially in the phyllosphere. You know rhizosphere, the root zone of the plant, the topmost soils, the topmost 15 centimeter soil. And what is phyllosphere? Phyllosphere means the above ground region of the plant. We call it physosphere. And rhizosphere is the below ground region of plant. We call rhizosphere. So microorganism present on the leaf surface, on the stem surface, external group of microorganism, and microorganism also present inside the plant, inside the cell, in between the cell in the plant, you know it. And there are lots of beneficial microorganisms. So what can we do? We can isolate this beneficial microorganism from the phyllosphere and from the rhizosphere. And it should be effective. It should be able to compete and persist in the environment. It should be able to colonize the plant. It should be able to colonize the harmful microbe, and their reproduction rate should be very high. The reproduction rate of beneficial microbe should be very high. And this beneficial microbe should be non-pathogenic to host plant. It should not cause any infection to the host plant, and it should not cause any harm to the environment. So these are the requirements, some of the requirements of beneficial microorganism. There are another requirement you can see here. It should be inexpensive in terms of production and formulation of agent. If it is very, very costly, then the farmers will compare the cost of biocontrol agent with the commercially pesticide. And they will compare it. And if the farmer see that the cost of biocontrol agents are much more higher than the chemical pesticide, then they will not choose the biocontrol agent. They will choose the chemical pesticide. So it should not be expensive. It should be inexpensive. And their self life, you see, should be longer. So if you formulate the biopesticide, for example, with the help of Trichoderma, and let's say you formulate Trichoderma-based biofungicide today, and this Trichoderma will be non-viable tomorrow, then you cannot exploit this Trichoderma species. It should be viable over the next few days or few months as a result, so that the company can manufacture it, can store it, and can market it to the farmers. And during this process, during this production, transportation, and storage, this beneficial microbe must survive. Only then we can apply to the environment. And even it should survive after application to the field. If, let's say, the biocontrol agent survive during production or transportation or storage, but don't survive after application in the field, immediately after application, they become dead, then those biocontrol agents will not be effective to control the harmful microorganism. Okay. That it should have high storage life, high shelf life. And I have already told the delivery and application must permit full expression of the agent. That is, their viability should not be deteriorated their ability to kill the pathogen, their ability to control the pathogen will not be deteriorated. And they must ensure agents will grow and achieve their purpose. You can see here, these are the trichoderma. These are thread-like structure. They actually capture the pathogen. And in this way, mycoparasitism start. You can see here, they take nutrition from the harmful pathogen. They trap it, they take nutrition, they become stronger. On the other hand, the pathogen become weaker. In this way, the pathogen will be killed by this trichoderma. So I will tell you some example that is plant pathogen controlled by trichoderma species. You can see here trichoderma, this is a beneficial fungus. There are a number of trichoderma species presently available in the agricultural soil, almost all agricultural soil. This trichoderma has antifungal ability, and it has been known since 1930. And these are the ways by which trichoderma species control plant disease. Number one, mycoparasitism, I already discussed, and nutrient competition. They compete for nutrient with the pathogen, and they take nutrition from the pathogen, mycoparasitism. You can see here. Then why do we need to develop a product that is readily available in the soil? You know that trichoderma is present in all soils, in the compost, in the rhizosphere soil, trichoderma present. Already trichoderma is present in the soil, in the agricultural field. Then why do we need to develop biopesticide from this trichoderma? And we need to apply this biopesticide to the soil again, where the trichoderma is already present in the soil. You know, here in the natural environment, there are a variation of trichoderma. That is heterokaryotic. You can see here, like that contain nuclei of this similar genotype within the single organism. You know, in the soil trichoderma are present, and these trichoderma are heterokaryotic. You can see here. On the other hand, the biocontrol agent should be homokaryotic. That is, it should contain nucleus which is similar or identical. And why does it necessary to maintain the similarity of biocontrol agents? Because we need genetic distinction. So we don't need variability. We need uniformity. And this is important for quality control. Otherwise, the quality will be deteriorated. If you formulate a biopesticide from the trichoderma or directly obtained from the natural sources, their quality will be deteriorated. We need homokaryotic trichoderma or homokaryotic biocontrol agent. You can see here, most strains have innate resistance to some agricultural chemicals, whereas some strains available for commercial use, and these are selected or modified for resistance to specific chemicals. So how is it applied, the biopesticide? So we isolate trichoderma, that is heterokaryotic, then we group it, we classify it, and we select only one trichoderma, for example, having the homokaryotic nature, and then we multiply this homokaryotic trichoderma, then we formulate this homokaryotic trichoderma, and we apply it to the soil. We can also use this biopesticide using homokaryotic trichoderma to treat the seed as well. So we use this biopesticide to treat the seed and to treat the soil. You can see here. And what happens actually when we apply to the rhizosphere zone, then what happens? Then this trichoderma will colonize the rhizosphere zone of the plant. You can see here, and can also be used as seed treating biopesticide. That is, we mix the
biological agent prokaryotic keno hote hoy.
Okay, I will tell you at the end of the class, please. So we can also use this biopesticide as seed treating agents. That is, we mix the seed to be sown in the field with the biocontrol agent. So what happens? There are some pathogens present on the seed surface, and there are some pathogens present inside the seed, inside the embryo, inside the endosperm. So what happens when we mix the seed with the biopesticide, especially with the trichoderma-based biopesticide? This trichoderma come in contact with the seed surface, you know, and they will establish on the seed surface. And if pathogen present on the seed surface, there will be mycoparasitism. The trichoderma will colonize on the pathogen, on the seed-borne pathogen. And in this colonization, the trichoderma will take nutrition from the pathogen, and the trichoderma will be stronger and the pathogen will be weaker. And they will secrete the cell wall degrading enzyme of pathogen. As a result, the structure of pathogen will be denatured, okay, in a way. You can see here what happens actually when the trichoderma come in contact with the pathogen. You can see here the trichoderma actually trap the pathogen, trap the Pythium. So this larger one, this is the Pythium, hypermycelium of Pythium. You can see here the vegetative structure, and this somewhat yellowish, these are the structure of trichoderma. So what happens? Trichoderma trap the Pythium. You can see here. And this attachment is supported by lectin carbohydrate interface. You can see here, after attachment, the trichoderma species secretes some lytic enzymes. Lytic means lysis, that is the breakdown of the cell, the breakdown of the tissues. So these are the enzymes, those will break down the cell and tissues. Chitinase will break down the chitin. Proteases, these are a group of enzymes which will break down the protein. You know, amino acids are the building block of protein, and protease enzyme will break down the protein and will produce amino acids. And glucanase, this is another enzyme which will break down glucose, if you can see here.
Sir, biological pesticide ক্ষেত্রে কি ডোজের বিষয় নাই, কেমিক্যালে যেরকম ডোজ গুলো স্পেসিফিক থাকে?
ওকে, আই উইল টেল ইউ এট দ্য এন্ড অফ দ্য ক্লাস, প্লিজ নোট ইট ডাউন। সো সাম স্ট্রেইনস কলোনাইজ দ্য রুট উইথ মাইকোপ্যারাসাইট প্রপার্টিস। ইউ ক্যান সি হিয়ার দ্য সাম ট্রাইকোডারমা স্পিসিস পেনিট্রেট দ্য রুট টিস্যু এন্ড ইনডিউস মেটাবলিক চেঞ্জেস হুইচ ইনডিউস রেজিস্ট্যান্স। হোয়াট হ্যাপেন্স, the beneficial fungus not only colonize the harmful fungus, for example, they also colonize the root of the plant. So when the root of the plant is colonized by the beneficial fungus trichoderma, so the metabolism of the plant is changed. So these beneficial microbes will induce some metabolic changes in the plant. And what are the changes occur in the plant when they come in contact with the beneficial fungus? Some reaction will be started, and the end product of these biochemical reactions will kill the pathogen or will make the plant resistant. For example, when the plant come in contact with the trichoderma species, some signaling pathway, for example, jasmonic acid signaling pathway, salicylic acid signaling pathway, these are the pathway will be activated. And at the end of this signaling pathway, some chemicals, biochemicals will be produced inside the plant, and those biochemical make the plant resistant. For example, phytoallergens. Phytoallergens will be produced in the plant, and phytoallergens make the plant resistant by a number of ways. And some chemicals will be produced. Those chemicals are toxic to the pathogen only, not to the beneficial microbe. You see here. So metabolism will be altered once the plant come in contact with the beneficial microorganism. And at the end of this process, the plant become resistant and the pathogen become weaker. You can see here from our department, two biopesticides have been developed, especially with the help of Trichoderma. One is BAU biofungicide, and another one is IPM lab biopesticides. Yeah. The new biofungicide was developed in the IPM laboratory of the Department of Plant Pathology by Professor Dr. Ismail Hussain, is a retired professor at the moment. And IPM lab biopesticide is also developed with the help of Trichoderma species by Professor Dr. Bahadur Mia. Both are retired professors in our department, and these are commercial available biofungicide and biopesticides. Both pesticides are based on Trichoderma. So we use this biopesticide to treat the soil. We mix the seed with this biopesticide. We can also apply this biopesticide in the soil, and these are transplant starter. And this biopesticide protect root from disease caused by a number of soil-borne pathogens. For example, Pythium, Rhizoctonia, Fusarium. Not only this pathogen, but also another soil-borne pathogen cause root disease in the plant. So we can apply this biopesticide to Rhizosporidium, you know, Rhizosporidium, and the pathogen, especially the soil-borne pathogen, will be controlled by this biopesticide, by a number of ways, you know, mycoparasitism and nutrient competition. This Pythium will compete with the Trichoderma for nutrient. And in this competition, Trichoderma win and Pythium lose. Or in this competition, Trichoderma win and soil-borne microorganism or soil-borne pathogen lose. Okay. They interact with the rhizosphere near the root here and increases the available form of nutrient needed by plants. So what are the other functions of these biocontrol agents? You know, in the soil, there are some chemical, conjugated chemicals present. The plant cannot uptake those conjugated chemicals. So what does the plant can do? The plant can take the only the readily available nutrient, for example, potassium, sodium, nitrogen, you can see here, then phosphorus. So those nutrient can form conjugate chemicals in the soil, but the plant cannot take the conjugated chemical. What the beneficial microbe do? Beneficial microbe release this readily available, release this nutrient element to the rhizosphere zone. As a result, the plant can uptake. So what are the future development? What can we do? You know, in the beneficial microbe, there are some genes. You can see here, those genes we can exploit to develop resistant variety. We can clone several genes from Trichoderma species that make the plant resistance, because the functions of Trichoderma are controlled by a number of genes of Trichoderma. So we can identify those genes of Trichoderma, then we can use or exploit those genes to develop resistant variety. So in future, we can exploit the target gene of beneficial microbes to incorporate this gene in the plant. For example, you know here, the Bt brinjal. This is the resistant variety to the brinjal shoot and fruit borer. But you know, what is the Bt gene? Bt gene is present in the bacterium Bacillus thuringiensis. So that gene produce toxic, and this toxic substance kill the brinjal shoot and fruit borer. So what the scientist did? The scientist identified that gene, and the scientist exploit that genes to develop resistant variety of brinjal. That is the gene of Bacillus thuringiensis, the Bt gene. You can see here, the Bt gene is transferred from the Bacillus thuringiensis to the brinjal plant. As a result, the brinjal plant produce toxic. As a result, brinjal shoot and fruit borer cannot cause infestation to the brinjal plant. That is the gene of Bacillus is transferred to the brinjal. And similarly, we can transfer the gene of Trichoderma to the target plant we are cultivating. So what are the questions you asked me?
Biopesticide dose bishoyta.
Okay. So you know about the dose, we have to apply the pesticide in accurate dose. In case of chemical pesticide, the dose is very, very minimum, 0.3% or 0.2% solution or 0.3% solution. That is, we have to mix 1 milliliter pesticide in 1 liter water. In 1 liter water, if the dose is 0.1%, we need only 1 milliliter pesticide. On the other hand, the dose of biopesticide is high. For example, we can use 3 gram BAU biofungicide to treat 1 kg seed. On the other hand, we need, you can see here, and not 3 gram, but also we use maybe 30 gram, maybe 50 gram we can use in case of biopesticide. The rate is usually higher and it doesn't cause harm to the environment. It doesn't cause harm to the plant. It doesn't cause harm to the beneficial microbe. But if the dose of chemical pesticide is higher than 0.2%, then it will kill the plant. It will kill all the beneficial microbe along with the harmful microbe. So in case of dose, you have to be careful when the term comes in chemical pesticide. Yes, you can control because Trichoderma will colonize the seed, for example. It can enter the seed. It will colonize the seed. It will colonize the root. So you can also control the internal pathogen with the help of Trichoderma. Trichoderma will enter the plant, will penetrate the plant. How Trichoderma penetrate the plant? By secreting some enzymes. Those enzymes will make the cell wall soft, will degrade the cell wall, and it will enter the plant. You know, in the environment, we get a heterokaryotic Trichoderma, that is different types of Trichoderma, different strain. If you use this different strain, then the quality will not be similar, will not be same. So it will be deteriorated with the advancement of time. There will be mutation, always there will be mutation in the Trichoderma because of the pressure posed by the environment, posed by the plant. There will be mutation in the genome. So you cannot check whether your product is of good quality or not. So once you release a bioproduct, then after 1 year or after 6 months, you have to check the quality of this product. So you have to check at the time of releasing this bioproduct, you also have to check after 6 months. You have to collect sample from the market and you have to check whether the quality is same or similar or not. And by using the homokaryotic Trichoderma, we can check. Yes, we got this gene, for example, and that this gene is effective in controlling this plant disease. And we have to check after 6 months whether the same gene is present or not in the commercially available product. So to check the quality, we need homokaryotic biopesticide.
IPM lab biopesticide ke toiri korechen?
IPM lab biopesticide was developed by Professor Dr. Bahadur Mia. Hmm?
Ji sir.
Sir, is soil sensor te ki bolchen?
Yes.
Dr. Ismail Hussain sir te ki bolchilen sir?
BAU biofungicide was developed by Professor Dr. Ismail.
And sir, trichoderma ki physosphere penetrate korte parbe ba planter above part e?
Not. So this can survive in the soil. We apply this trichoderma based biopesticide in the soil. So they will colonize the root zone of the plant. They cannot, but you can control the seed borne pathogen by this trichoderma. So in this case, we mix the seed with the trichoderma based biopesticide. And we have to keep it, for example, 24 hours or 48 hours. But you cannot control the foliar one. But nowadays, you can make the liquid formulation with trichoderma, and this liquid can be spread with the plant surface. Yes, in other sense, you can control some foliar pathogen by making the liquid formulation.
Sir, why use biological control at porous slide?
এখানে যে পানি ছিল না আবার আসলো পানি ওখানে বসে কি বসে ছিল আসুন বলতেছি
আর মাইকোপ্যারাসাইটিজমটা যদি আরেকবার একটু বলবেন
ইউ নো দা প্যারাসাইটিজম রাইট মাইকোপ্যারাসাইটিজম মিন্স when one fungus takes nutrition from the another fungus when the fungus serves as the parasite and another species serves as the host we call it mycoparasitism. You know, when the term parasitism occurs, one is parasite, one is host, right? So in this case, fungus is the parasite and host might be another fungus or might be another species of microorganism. This one?
Sir, it's a point.
So trichoderma is one example of beneficial microbe. There are several beneficial microbes. For example, Pseudomonas fluorescens, Bacillus subtilis. Even there are some beneficial nematode. For example, Heterodaptitis. This nematode cause infection to the insect, to the harmful insect. We called it entomopathogenic nematode. So there are a group of beneficial microbes. It might be fungi, bacteria, nematode, etc. So we can exploit this group of microbe to control the harmful microbe.
Sir, antibiosis are destructive mycoparasitism and pathukotaki.
So antibiosis means antibiotic substance produced from the beneficial microbe. Okay, that is beneficial microbe produce a substance. That substance can kill or can control the harmful microbe. This process is known as antibiosis or antibiotic. You know, the azithromycin, this is antibiotic, right? For example, in this case, duitamycin, this is antibiotic. This antibiotic is produced by the beneficial bacterium Bacillus cereus. Okay, and this antibiotic can kill Phytophthora. And this is the oomycin. And what's the question? Mycoparasitism. And mycoparasitism is when the beneficial microbe take nutrition from the harmful microbe. That is, beneficial microbe survive on the harmful microbe. We call it mycoparasitism. That is the fungus, for example, trichoderma takes nutrition from another fungus, for example, Fusarium. We call it mycoparasitism. And this mycoparasitism is facilitated by secretion of cell wall degrading enzyme. What happens? Trichoderma secret cellulase, for example, this cellulase degrade the cell of Fusarium species and After degradation of cell wall, trichoderma takes nutrition from the got it?
এইদিকে আমার অ্যাটেন্ডেন্স মানে কি যে করতেছে আমি বুঝতেছি না স্যারের।